Language forms a bond between different people. When your app can speak natively to your users, it gives a feeling that your app was made just for them. It's a personal and local experience delivered on a global scale. With Tizen 2.4 set to be released in the coming months, one API that can make a huge impact is the Localization API. Hi everyone, it's Michael from Samsung Developers. Our episode today will teach you how to localize your app by adding languages that your app can support. We'll show you how to set up, a quick demo, and a few good practices to keep in mind. But first, let's take note of the requirements. To localize your app, all you need is the latest Tizen IDE. You won't need any additional libraries to import or privileges and features to add. Just head over to developer.tizen.org to download the latest IDE and SDK. All you need for testing is the emulator to test various languages. But when you need to test on an actual device, try out the remote test lab at developer.samsung.com. When setting up for your project's localization, there are three things to remember: folder structure, files, and the script tag in your HTML pages. The first step is to create a new folder named Locales in your project's root. Inside the Locales folder, the languages are distinguished by the Internet Assigned Numbers Authority or IANA language tags. In our example, we'll be showing English and Korean translations of our app. The second step is to add folders to our languages, EN for English and KO for Korean assets. Now let's see how to handle the files. For the third step, we should add language.js to our files. This will be a JSON file which contains the key value pairs of our translated text. It's important to remember that Tizen uses JSON to keep the translations. If you open both language.js files, you'll see that they have the same key value pairs. The only difference is that one file's values are in English and the other is in Korean. We also have an image called hello.jpg in the images folder for both languages. But if you'll take a look at each file, you'll notice that each one is natively targeted to its user. The last item is the script tag. Our app today only has one page, so we'll add the script tag there with the source pointing to language.js. Tizen takes care of choosing which set of assets to load depending on the user's device language. Time to show you how to apply these in the project and code. Let's begin by creating a new Tizen web project and call it Local App. Add the new folder and name it Locales. Inside Locales, let's add our supported languages by folder. With our folder structure done, let's put our assets per page. Since Tizen uses JSON for strings of text, let's create a JavaScript file called language.js starting with English. The keys we include here should be the same across all languages for ease of use. We're placing a string for every text-holding object in our page, which will be set by JavaScript code later. Do the same for the Korean language. Now that the folders and files are done, let's take care of the script tag in our page. Open index.html and add the script tag under the main JavaScript file with the source pointing to language.js. Because we want all text in our app to be localized, we should add ID attributes to the elements we want translated. This is so our JavaScript code will be able to identify and modify these later. For the body of our app, there are three simple elements: a paragraph, a button, and an image. The paragraph is called Par Greeting because all it will do is greet the user. The button is called BTN Birthday, and once it is tapped, it will greet the user a happy birthday. Lastly, the image is added to show how Tizen decides which set of assets to use. The image only has to say the name of the source file. All the image says is hello in both English and Korean. With a page design done, head over to the source code. A function called loadLanguage was added and is called towards the end of the init function when the page is loaded. Inside the loadLanguage function, let's put the code to have our page use the data from the JSON data. All we have to do is specify the key of the value we would like applied to our page. Don't forget to add the sayHappyBirthday function from earlier. The code here is also the same as loadLanguage, only this time, the greeting paragraph will now show happy birthday to the user in his or her language. That's all there is to it. Time for a demo. Opening our app, we see that everything is in English. Tapping on our button even greets us in English. So what happens when we switch to Korean? Our app didn't change yet because it is still in memory, so let's close our app now. And then relaunch it. Now you'll see that everything is in Korean. So what happens when we switch to a language we didn't prepare for? You'll see that it used dummy values for all the elements. Now let's talk about best practices for avoiding problems like these. In the demo, you saw that everything was working great as long as we chose the language we prepared for. But things went bad when we chose an unexpected language. Here are some helpful tips to remember. Your locales folder is treated like the root folder when the phone is using a language your app supports. When the phone uses an unsupported language, it uses the assets found in the root. This means that you should have a copy of your default language images in the root's images folder and the language.js file in the root as seen in this illustration. So when the phone uses an unsupported language, you have assets to fall back onto. Since you'll be dealing with a lot of strings, you should have a standard with naming conventions. It's up to you how you would like to approach this. In our sample app, I started paragraph strings with par and button strings with btn. Time to wrap up our episode. Localizing your Tizen app helps bring a personal and local experience to your globally deployed app. When localizing your app, remember to first check your folders, then your assets and files, and finally your script tags. Just place them properly and Tizen decides which assets to use given the phone's language. Refer to the Internet Assigned Numbers Authority or IANA language tags to correctly name your language folders. Remember that your locales folder is treated like a root folder when the phone uses a language your app supports. Have files and assets in your root folder in case the user chose a language your app doesn't support yet. That concludes our tutorial on localizing your Tizen apps for a global audience. We hope you can provide even better personal experiences now that you know how localization works. For more details on Tizen localization and the upcoming Tizen 2.4, check out developer.tizen.org for more help and guides. If you have any questions, feel free to post them on developer.tizen.org and at developer.samsung.com. Please hit like and subscribe to the Samsung Developers channel to watch out for more tutorials like this. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you again soon.